These Arkansas Game and Fish Commission biologists are in search of living fossils.
Below the dam and in the old river channel is where we've had the most luck.
Game and fish crews typically use electrofishing boats or commercial fishing nets to capture their research subjects. But today's target is no ordinary quarry, so the fishing techniques differ from the usual methods.
We're jugging for alligator gar, the state's largest freshwater fish. And we're using jug system, using bullet floats, about 3 feet a leader, a steel leader, and a 5-aught treble hook baited with rough fish. This is buffalo. We'll set these out in the river channel and let them float and see what kind of gator gar we catch.
Alligator gar don't exactly invoke warm and fuzzy feelings. From their incredible size to their formidable teeth, alligator gar usually inspire more fear than admiration.
If you look at the top of the head, you understand where they get their name.
While alligator gar may not be the most attractive fish in Arkansas waters, there's plenty to respect about this species.
They're the largest fish we've got. They're cool, they're long-lived, they're ancient. They've been around for millions of years looking at fossil records. This species is a long-lived. It persists where no other species will persist.
And they've persisted for a very long time. Fossil records indicate alligator gar have been around for more than 100 million years, which is why the species is often called a living fossil. But if recent population declines aren't halted, the fossil record may be future generations' only link to these prehistoric survivors. Despite living on Earth since the early Cretaceous period, alligator gar have seen far better times. Habitat changes in major rivers have limited the species' ability to spawn. Combine that with a largely unwarranted reputation as a predator of popular sport fish, and you have the makings for the current downward trend in alligator gar populations.
As the employees of the Game and Fish Commission, we have been charged with conserving and protecting all species of animals in the state of Arkansas. When we see a species declining like alligator gar has been across its range, it is our primary task to try to conserve this species throughout the state.
Although not listed as an endangered or threatened species, alligator gar aren't nearly as common in Arkansas as they once were. That's part of the reason Game and Fish biologist Eric Brinkman has assembled the agency's alligator gar management team here on the Lower Washita River near Felsenthal Lock and Dam. Little research has been conducted on the state's alligator gar population, so Brinkman's team is gathering data to gain a better understanding of how many fish exist in Arkansas's rivers and which habitats they prefer. But first, you have to catch them. The alligator gar management team employs a fishing method that incorporates jug fishing and traditional rod and reel fishing. After baiting the jug lines with rough fish such as shad, buffalo, and carp, the crews throw out the floats and the waiting game begins. As the floats drift downstream in the current, the crews keep a watchful eye, waiting for an alligator gar to take the bait. When that happens, a crew will wait as long as 15 minutes for a fish to hook itself before tracking down the jug and clipping a line to the float. And that's when things get interesting. After a successful capture, the crews take the alligator gar for a short boat ride to a makeshift laboratory on the riverbank.
41.
Weights and measurements are taken.
725 on girth.
But sizing up a massive gar isn't the easiest task. By taking a small tissue sample from the fish's pectoral fin, biologists can determine the genetic makeup of fish and look for similarities and differences between fish from different waterways.
We're doing a genetic survey of all the alligator gar in Arkansas. We're trying to get 30 tissue samples, just little bitty fin clips that we're sending off to a lab that will look at the genetic diversity across the state, across drainages, even compared to other states and their alligator gar populations.
To keep track of individual fish over time, biologists implant a small transponder into each alligator gar they catch.
This little tag right here, we're going to stick near his tail fin. And this has got a unique number that we can identify this fish. If we catch him later on, we can see what kind of growth rates he's had. There's no electricity in the tag itself, but when you use this wand, it activates the tag and tells you the number of the tag.
Through this kind of work, the gar management team has estimated that the Lower Washita River alligator gar population consists of just a few hundred fish, which is the reason this type of research is only getting started.
That was on buoy number 10. It was called at 10:08.
The Arkansas Game and Fish Commission's alligator gar research is helping the agency's biologists gain a better understanding of a fish that's becoming less common in Arkansas waters.
Range-wide, the populations are getting smaller, less frequent.
But it's not easy to get your hands on a fish that can exceed 8 feet in length and weigh more than 300 pounds. The Game and Fish Commission's alligator gar management team uses a system of jug lines and rod and reels to capture its fish. It's obviously the highlight of the team's research. In addition to gathering data from each fish, the Gator Gar team also implants transmitters in some fish. Stationary receivers can tell researchers when a fish has passed near a specific area, and portable tracking devices help the team pinpoint fish. Together, the data are helping the Game and Fish Commission develop population models and determine which habitats are most important to this ancient species.
Alligator gar breathe air. So they're quite fine, as long as you keep them moist. They should not die.
But why should we be concerned with the fish that many have historically considered bad? Although it's now considered shameful history, There was a time when some state conservation agencies encouraged anglers to kill gar.
We're still battling that stigma of all gar in general being, you know, just a trash fish, not worth anything but killing. This is the apex predator in the population, and you need that apex predator to help control the other fish species. You don't want any species to get out of control. I can't say that they won't eat a sport fish when they have the opportunity. They will. All fish will eat other sport fish when they have an opportunity. Now, the majority of their diet is what is most abundant in the water bodies that they're in. It's usually shad, buffalo, carp, and other rough fish that are not being utilized by anything else.
The Arkansas Game and Fish Commission has established a conservative one alligator gar per day regulation, and any recreational angler who attempts to catch one must first obtain a free alligator gar permit. Between May 1st and July 1st, during the alligator gar spawn, all gar over 36 inches must be immediately released. About 500 anglers a year receive an alligator gar permit, and about 5% of them actually catch one.
On a population that may only reproduce every 7 to 10 years, what may seem an insignificant amount of take can build up over time and impact a population that may only be a few hundred fish.
The alligator gar's life history and man-made habitat changes are the biggest contributing factors in the species' spawning limitations. Alligator gar males don't reach sexual maturity until about 7 years, and it's double that for females. Because alligator gar rely on a river's floodplain for spawning activities, they can't spawn as often as they did before humans altered many of the South's major rivers.
The populations have been impacted significantly by what humans have done across the aquatic landscape. Dredging, channelization, levees, all that disconnects the rivers from the floodplains, which this species is very dependent on that floodplain, particularly for spawning. They need that flooding period that we've tried to control and limit for reproduction, and we're just not getting the consistent flooding like we did 100 years ago.
Alligator gar aren't just an important part of the ecosystem. They're also a remarkable fish, worthy of conservation efforts in their own right. They're not only Arkansas's largest fish, but also the state's longest-lived fish species. Game and fish biologists have aged one alligator gar at 68 years. This specimen, caught by a commercial fisherman on the White River in 2004, measured 8 feet 2 inches and weighed a whopping 240 pounds. The Game and Fish Alligator Gar team hopes fish like that will entice more anglers to respect the species and seek out alligator gar for their sport fishing potential.
This is just a really cool fish. It fights good. It's historically had a tremendous trophy fishery in the state, especially on the White River in the 40s and 50s. We have them here. We want to utilize them on a conservative basis, you know, provide another opportunity for our anglers to go after a trophy fish in the state of Arkansas.
To reach that end, Arkansas's alligator gar team will continue its research. Today, it's the lower Washita River, but these fish also inhabit the White, Arkansas, Red, Mississippi, Cache, and St. Francis rivers. Where the gar team hasn't been, they'll soon be, taking stock of these living fossils and ensuring the alligator gar's future for generations to come.